Hi, hello and welcome. This is your favorite chef Shribala. I hope you would love my recipes. Please like, share, comment and subscribe to my channel and click the bell icon to turn the notifications on. Enjoy and happy cooking.
We are going back to the Agraharam today and we are going to learn a Tamil Nadu style avial. Avial, if you see, there is a Kerala style, then you have a Tamil Nadu style, and both the states have got their own regional variations also. But what we are going to do right now is a Kumbakonam style of avial with a seasoning of mustard and curry leaves in coconut oil. I'm going to do that. And what is the difference between a Kerala and a Tamil Nadu avial? The way you grind the masala to the way you select the vegetables. Which vegetables you select, all of it varies. So probably little later I'll definitely teach you how a Kerala avial is going to be done. Under Kerala again you have got a Nadan avial and then a contemporary style avial. There is a lot and lots of things which can be learned under one dish called the avial. But today it is going to be the Tamil Nadu Kumbakonam style avial. Come, let's see it.
Kindly make a note of the ingredients needed. These are all the roots and vegetables you need. And then I'm giving you the masala ingredients also. I'm showing you the vegetables, the way it has been cut along with the masala. So if you see, these are all the vegetables cut in large chunks. You need to keep them ready before starting the avial. Two things you need to do. The broad beans, that is the mocha, has to be soaked and cooked prior. Similarly, the taro root, the sepankalanga in Tamil, that also needs to be pre-boiled and kept. Rest of it you can cook it that minute. The other important tip which you need to remember is which vegetable to add at the bottom, which vegetable to add at the top. If you see, I'm adding carrot and beans first, then the drumstick. Of course, I'm going to add the yam on the fourth. I'm going to add very little of water. I'm taking a glass of water, in that I'm only filling half of it. I'm pouring it, then a pinch of turmeric, closing the lid, and I'm going to boil it. In the meanwhile, the grated coconut, then the cumin or the jeera with the green chilies. I'm going to make a masala out of it. The cumin has been added now, then the green chili. It has to be ground coarse, not fine paste or smooth. See the way I've ground it. This is how you need to grind it. You can sprinkle little more water after that and grind it and keep it aside. Now it's boiling. I'm going to add the other vegetable, which is the ash gourd, the vellapushni. So this is very, very important. Why we are doing this is the vegetable should not overboil and become very mushy. They should have their own individual identity. Next, I'm adding the raw banana. You can add snake gourd, cluster beans. All these can be added. Next, the pumpkin. Pumpkin will boil very faster, so I'm adding at the end. Again, I'm going to close the lid. I'm not added extra water, remember that. The initial water alone is sufficient. After 10 minutes, if you see, it would have completely boiled. Now I am going to add the pre-cooked mocha or the broad beans and the taro root, the sepankalanga, which has been already boiled and peeled. These two needs to be done prior. See the whole video, make a note of it and then start cooking avial to get a understanding. This is done now. All the vegetables have been added. So I am adding the salt. I do not add salt while it is boiling because we are adding all the vegetables in stages. Then the masala goes. Gently toss it don't break the vegetables. I'll show you how to set the curd. This is the curd. In that, I'm adding very little of salt and I'm going to add sugar. The reason is we don't want it to be too sour. I'm going to pour it on this. After adding curd, do not give it a boil. It will break the flavors. You'll have to be very, very careful about it. See the consistency of the curd. It has to be really thick and not too sour. A slight tinge of sourness should be there, but it should not spoil the taste of the avyal. I'll give you a tip. This is the boiled water. In that, I make a rasam. I soak the tamarind and keep it ready. This is done now. I'm going to gently toss it without breaking the vegetables. I'll show you how to season this also. I'm adding coconut oil because it will add flavors to the avyal. Then I'm crackling the mustard. The key difference between a Kerala avyal and Tamil Nadu avyal is the seasoning. And of course the selection of roots and vegetables. The next important thing in a Kumbakonam avyal is the curry leaves won't be taken out of the stock. The whole sprig will be added. I'm going to pour it on top and gently leave it without tossing so that the flavors absorb nicely. I won't toss this now, I will leave it. You can even put a lid and close it for a while, say 5 minutes. So, a yummy Kumbakonam avyal is ready to be served. I hope you love this recipe and give me your feedback. Until we meet again, you can always follow me in all the other social media. The links are given in the description. See you soon. Take care.